Hi, this is Mike Maloney, and we've got the annual In Gold We Trust report, and we've got with us Ronnie Stoffele from Incrementum AG. How are you doing, Ronnie?
Hey, Mike. Good to see you. How are you?
Great, great. It's wonderful having you back here once again. For any viewers that are new, we periodically do this with Ronnie because he and his guys at Incrementum do some of the best broad spectrum analysis, where they're really taking a look at the big picture. And they come out with a gold report every year. So let's get right into this, Ronnie. What is it that you want to talk about in your chart book here first?
Well, you know, the leitmotif of the report, and you know, that's the front page. So it is monetary climate change. Now it is a bit provocative, I would say, because nowadays it seems that everything is all about you know, a more sustainable economy. It's about ESG, SRI, and so on. I saw an advertisement for a beer recently where they said it is produced carbon neutral. So this is really a topic that is now all over. But for us, especially as we're approaching the 50th anniversary of the birth of our monetary system, of our new monetary system, and let's say the separation of the world monetary system from gold. For us, it's really important to say that our monetary system is not sustainable, and that this highly inflationary politics is not sustainable, that the debt situation is not sustainable, and that those policies have got enormous consequences for the structure of our economy, for financial markets, for our society. So we basically describe this monetary climate change that has happened over the last couple of months, where basically, from our point of view, we're shifting from an environment where deflationary forces were stronger now to an environment where the pendulum is swinging into the direction of increasing inflation. So in the report, we mainly describe those triggers for inflationary forces getting stronger. And yeah, you know, like every year we try to write a little bit less. We ended up with 350 pages because there's just so much going on that we want to discuss and to analyze and to share with our readers.
Yeah, I want to tell everybody that the In Gold We Trust report is available in basically two versions. There's the full version and then sort of the executive summary version. So if you can't read a 350-page report, please download the executive summary version at least, because this is important stuff. So so let's hit the first thing in the chart book here.
Well, we could start talking about gold if you want, Mike, because obviously that's what the viewers are probably most interested in. We could talk about the performance of gold. As we can see here, 2020 was a terrific year for gold. It was up 24.6% in US dollar terms. In euro terms, it was up almost 15%. And I think it's interesting that so many people were, let's say, a bit dissatisfied with the performance of gold in 2020. I would say, and I think this is also your view, Mike, that gold's role is not to make you rich. The role of gold is to protect your purchasing power, is to protect your savings. And I think that gold did a tremendous job in 2020. As I've said, being up 25% in US dollar terms, it acted as a portfolio stabilizer in this highly volatile year. It acted as a hedge within the recession. It reacted very quickly to rising inflation expectations. But then I think after hitting the all-time high in summer of last year, of course, we saw some headwinds and yields were rising. I think Bitcoin also, to some degree, stole a bit of the attention from market participants. Later on, we saw a stronger US dollar. But I think in general, gold did a tremendous job last year. This year so far, it is down 4.8%, which is quite okay, I would say, given the circumstances. But what is interesting, at the moment, we are basically trading at the exact same level like 1 year ago. Now, if I compare the sentiment now to 1 year ago, I would say that it's a tremendous opportunity, because 1 year ago, the sentiment already was extremely positive. Now, I think nobody really cares about gold. I think gold is doesn't grab any attention. I don't see very strong positioning based on a commitment of traders report. Sentiment indicators are basically neutral area. So I think this is a very good setup, and therefore we continue to forecast new all-time highs in this year.
Yeah, I absolutely agree. Right now, the sentiment, it's so weird. The economy is just so weird. Everything is like being torn two directions at once. I do believe that we're probably going to see some sort of whipsaw with a deflationary market crash that'll be short-lived, but the overall theme is going to be inflation and big inflation. When you talk about the 50-year-old monetary system, I look at all the charts and I get the world has new monetary systems periodically. This is has been normal. The monetary system shifts. And when I look at all of the charts, I see a monetary system that is in its death throes right now. And people aren't getting ready. And those who are prepared, I think, will do very well. And there are these periods of time where gold doesn't just protect your wealth, but it also becomes the best performing asset. 1979, 1980, that was one of those. The 1970s, you made enormous gains in absolute purchasing power. In the United States, if you had sold your house and bought gold by 1980, if you were able to sell your gold at the peak, you could buy 17 of the same, or maybe, no, that was silver, I'm sorry, 17 of the same homes. I can't remember what gold was, but it was like 12 or something like that. But it was an incredible gain of absolute wealth, the amount of purchasing power. So anyway, let's move on to the next chart in your book here. Tell us what you think.
Well, that shows the annual average gold price, and it has reached a new all-time high last year. And since the beginning of the year, we are higher again. So we are seeing a new record average price of gold, which is, of course, very, very important for the gold miners. They had their most profitable year last year. I think this year will be better. And as you can see on this chart, since the IPO of gold on 15th of August, 1971, on average, gold was up 10.2%, which is a compound annual growth rate of 7.9%, which is, from my point of view, pretty decent. And I think going forward, we should not forget that the third quarter is showing the strongest seasonality. So therefore, I think it's a very nice entry point, in combination with this sentiment that is pretty neutral or negative. So gold is in a solid bull market. I think we saw a correction since the all-time highs. Now nobody really cares. So that gives me quite a lot of confidence, I would say, going forward.
I agree. And one of the things I want to point out in this chart of the average annual price, this is annual, so you're not talking about the peaks. So you're talking about a little bit over a $600 annual price average in 1980. But gold went above 850. It was actually over 900 in some futures markets. But I want the viewers to take a look at the blue line on here. That's the year-over-year change. And what you see is when this bull market started, you've got to look at where the 0% line is on the right-hand scale and imagine a line going straight across there. And so when it's above that zero line, the gold price is rising that year, year over year change. And so you've got those years from 2001 to 2011, and then from 2019 to and 2020, you know, there's a few years here that we were above. Take a look at what the bull market looks like back in the 70s of the year over year change. We haven't even started this yet. We haven't even gotten there. We're about, you know, once we exceed our previous high again, or once the next crisis happens, you're going to see these immense gains where, you know, you had in 1980, you had almost a 100% gain in gold in that 1 year. We haven't touched these areas yet. So this bull market really, to me, has barely begun. And it's your year over year change in price data that shows me this. What do you think?
Yeah, well, we've got a fantastic interview with Fofo, a friend of a friend of another, which is a blogger which writes about free gold, and he rightly says gold will be repriced once, and that will be more than enough. So I think all this chatter about, you know, gold being up $50 or down $100, whatever, I think at some point this will be useless, because I think what you will really need in this transition phase from one monetary system to another monetary system, I think then it will really become important to hold gold. And I think, you know, just recently we saw some great gold purchases by central banks. Brazil bought, I think, 40 or 50 tons of gold. We saw Russia buying significant amounts of gold in July. We saw Hungary buying huge amounts of gold. It is no coincidence, because, as you know, Hungary is leading the charts of the world's biggest hyperinflations. So I think, you know, the most important players, they are already kind of preparing for this transition from one monetary system to another. And I think this is really the end game. And I think, you know, with the whole COVID crisis, I think we got much closer to this end game of our monetary system. So long story short, I would only get nervous about holding gold if I would expect real interest rates to rise significantly. And if we should see real rates at plus 3 or 4%, then I think it would be wise to reduce your gold holdings. But as we know, due to the debt situation, this is simply not possible. So this makes me pretty much relaxed about gold going forward. And I would say that this setup for gold for the next couple of years is as good as it gets.
Yes, I believe that with this monetary reset, you know, that thing that you said about gold being repriced once. So that's if there's a complete change in the monetary system. When that happens, I think anybody invested in gold is going to see a many-fold increase in their real wealth, their purchasing power. And it'll only happen once. So this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. I want to thank you. This is going to end this segment, but join us in the next segment, everybody, because we got lots more from Ronnie Stoffele of Incrementum AG. Thank you, Ronnie.
Thank you. See you soon.